You're watching the chapter number 2 of the Blender modeling course, where we'll be creating the 3D model of a guitar in Blender, and along with that we'll be learning lots of modeling tools and techniques. And not just that, we'll also be creating some materials to be applied on the guitar model. Also, if you are someone who's new to the Blender modeling course, then you can check out the previous chapter of this course by using the link given in the description of this video. So I've opened a new Blender file, and the first thing that we're gonna do before modeling a guitar is to get a reference image of the guitar. So I searched on Google for some simple images of some guitars, and it showed all of these results of different kinds of guitars. So it depends upon you that which particular image you wish to choose as the reference image for your project. And after searching for a few images, I found this image of the guitar, which I think will be the best to be used as a reference image. So I will download this, and yes, I have also dropped the link of this image in the description of this video, so you can download the image from there. So we are back in the scene, and to import that reference image in this Blender file, we need to add an image editor over here. So for this, I'll take my cursor over this end, then right click and select horizontal split. Then I'll move my cursor, and if I left click, then now this window is divided into two separate windows. Now in order to change the lower window into the image editor, simply click on this icon, and from here we'll be selecting the image editor. After this, we simply need to click on the open button and then choose that particular location where you have saved the reference image of the guitar. Then select it and click on the open image. And with this, we have added this reference image of the guitar in the image editor. Moving ahead, we'll now begin with the modeling part. And the object with which we'll be starting the modeling will be a circle. So first of all, press X to delete the cube. Now press Shift plus A, then go to Mesh and select the circle. Now to go to the edit mode, press Tab, and by default, there's no face in the circle. We are only having the vertices of the circle connected to each other. So our idea is basically to select these vertices individually and then move them around in order to create this bottom shape of the guitar first. So for this, let's first go to the top view by pressing 7 on the numpad. And first of all, we'll be deleting some of these top vertices. So I'll first select them, then press X to delete and select delete vertices. Now I'll select this vertex on the top, and similarly, I'll also select this particular vertex on the other side. Now let's slightly move them up in the Y axis, and to bring them closer, we simply need to scale them down in the X axis. So for this, press S, X, and like this, we'll bring these vertices closer in the X axis. Now we need to have some more vertices in order to form a shape like this. And for this purpose, we'll be using the extrude vertices tool. So in the last chapter, we understood about how the extrusion works for the faces. And in this particular chapter, let's also understand how the same extrusion tool can be used to extrude the vertices. So for this, let's first deselect everything, and now I'll select this particular vertex. Now if I press E to extrude it, then you will notice that we have one more vertex emerging out of the one that we previously selected. In fact, we can do this step multiple number of times in order to create any number of vertices. So whenever you extrude a vertex by pressing E, try to place it in such a position that we are able to create our target shape, which is the bottom part of the guitar model. And now if you want to have the same symmetrical shape for this right side also, then we can use a shortcut instead of again extruding each vertex one by one. And that shortcut is to use the mirror modifier. So first of all, we have to delete all the vertices on the second half. So I've selected all of them, then press X and select delete vertices. Now return back to the object mode, and with this object selected, we'll open the modify properties by clicking on this icon. Then go to add modifier, and in the generate category, here we have the mirror modifier. And since the X axis is selected in the mirror modifier, as a result, we have the same symmetry created on the other side. Also, if I zoom in, then you will notice that this top part is not yet closed. And if I select this particular vertex and press G to move it, then you will notice that it's very difficult to connect both of them together. And to solve this problem, we have the clipping option in the mirror modifier. So if I turn it on from here, and then if I try to move this selected vertex, then you will notice that it will not pass through the Y axis, and instead it will intersect with the top vertex on the other side of the symmetry. Moving ahead, if you want to give a slightly more circular shape to any part of the geometry, then for this we need to select both the vertices by holding the shift button, then right click and select subdivide. By doing this, we'll have an extra vertex added in the middle of both, and if I try to move it, then you will notice that this will give us a slightly more curved appearance. So if you want, you can try to do this with the other pair of vertices also, but for now I think that the basic shape for the guitar is completely ready. But right now we are only having these vertices forming a guitar like shape. However, in order to convert this into a 3D model, we need to have some faces in it. And to fill the faces, press A to select everything and press F, and this will fill the faces between the selected vertices. Also, to give it some thickness with all the vertices selected, press E and we'll extrude this in the Z axis. Also, to give it an interesting shape, let's add some loop cuts over here. So press Ctrl plus R, then left click, and for the first loop cut, we'll fix its position over here. Now press Ctrl plus R again, again to add another loop cut, then left click, and for this one we'll be placing it near the bottom part. Now left click to finalize, and with this we are having two loop cuts added in this side region. Let's also apply this mirror modifier permanently to this object. So return back to the object mode by pressing the tab key, then go to the mirror modifier, click on this icon and select apply. Now press tab to go to the edit mode again, and now to select the top faces to apply the inset effect, I'll first select this one, then with the shift key hold it, I'll also select the other one. Now to apply the inset faces effect, press I, and if I slightly move my cursor towards the faces, then here we have the inset effect applied. Similarly, we'll now select these two bottom faces, and to apply the inset faces effect, press I and move the cursor like this. Then left click to finalize, and now we are having this basic structure of the guitar's body ready in Blender. Moving ahead, in order to give it a slightly more realistic look, we'll be applying the subdivision surface modifier. So return back to the object mode, then go to the modify properties, click on add modifier, then in the generate, we'll be selecting the subdivision surface modifier. Then in the levels viewport, I'll increase this to a value of 2, and now you can notice that this guitar is having a much higher realistic and a natural appearance. Also, to give it some smoothness, right click and apply shade auto smooth. Now the next thing that we'll do is to create this top part of the guitar's body, and for this purpose, we'll be using a plane object in the scene. So press shift plus A, then go to mesh and select the plane. Now press 7 on the numpad to go to the top view, and yes, do remember that we are using this image in the image editor only as a reference image and not as an exact copy of what we'll model. We'll only be taking some ideas from this image and then add our own creativity to our 3D model. Now returning back to the modeling part, with this plane selected, press tab to go to the edit mode, and we'll scale it down in the x-axis. Also, to see everything properly, let's turn on the x-ray mode by pressing alt plus z. Now press 1 for the vertex select mode, and with all the vertices selected, we'll move this up in the y-axis. So let's place it over here, and let's again reduce its scaling in the x-axis like this. Also, for the remaining part on the top, I will select these two vertices and we'll move them up in the y-axis like this. Then press E to extrude it in the y-axis and left click to finalize. Let's again do the same thing. So we'll again extrude it in the y-axis and we'll take this top part at a slightly more height as compared to the previous one. Now let's scale it up in the x-axis like this. Now go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad, press A to select everything, and we'll move this up in the z-axis. So let's place it over here. Then we'll be selecting the vertices over here, and yes, to ensure that both of these vertices are selected. Now from the side view, we'll move them down slightly in the z-axis and left click to finalize. Now in order to give it some thickness, if I press A to select all, and if I try to extrude it by pressing E, then you will notice that it is taking the local z-axis into consideration, and as a result, these angles that you can see here are not at perfect 90 degrees. And to solve this problem, we have a tool in the extrusion only, which is known as the extrude faces along normals. And to access it, let's first press Ctrl plus Z to undo the extrusion, then press Alt plus E, and from this menu, select the extrude faces along normals. Now I'll move my cursor in the upward direction, and now you will notice that all the faces will get extruded along their normal directions, which is basically perpendicular or at 90 degrees to the respective faces. And so with this, we are having the basic structure of the guitar neck ready in our scene. Also, with all the top vertices selected, I'll slightly move them down in the z-axis in order to make this a little bit thinner. Then left click to finalize. Now moving ahead, the next thing that we'll be doing is creating these tuning keys on the top of the guitar. So for this, let's first come out of the edit mode. Now press shift plus A, go to mesh and add a plane object. Let's move it in the y-axis and place it over here. Now press tab to go to the edit mode, and we'll scale it down like this. Also, go to the top view by pressing 7 on the numpad, and we'll also enable the x-ray mode. Now with all the vertices of this plane selected, we'll first move it in the x-axis and place it over here. Then we'll scale it down slightly, and now you might have seen that in guitars, we usually have the shape of the tuning keys just like in this image. And to create a similar shape in our Blender project also, we'll be using this plane and a cylinder object. So first of all, I will select these two faces and we'll scale them up in the y-axis and left click to finalize. Then I'll select these two faces and we'll slightly move them ahead in the x-axis. Now go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad, and to bring them up, let's first select all of them by pressing A, then press G to move them in the z-axis. So let's place them over here. Let's also scale them down slightly like this. After this, to give it some thickness, press E to extrude it in the z-axis and left click to finalize. Now let's again go to the top view by pressing 7 on the numpad, and while being in the edit mode, if I press shift plus A, then you will observe that this mesh menu will appear, and suppose I select the cylinder object, then it will get added at the position of the 3D cursor. However, if I go to the scene collection, then you will notice that the name of the cylinder object is not visible, and that is because whenever we add anything in the edit mode of any particular object, then that extra object will also become a part of that object which is being edited. So in this particular case, we were editing this particular plane with the name plane.001, and as a result, this cylinder is now a part of this plane only. Now with the cylinder selected, press G, Y and move it over here. Also, let's scale it down. So press S to scale it down and left click to finalize. Now let's change change the angle and let's first move it in the Z axis. So we'll place it over here. Then for the rotation, we'll be rotating it in the Y axis by 90 degrees. So press R, Y and enter 90 in the numpad. Now go to the top view again. Let's scale it down and to increase its length, press S, X and scale it up like this. Now press G to move it and we'll place it over here. So basically we have to ensure that this cylinder and the plane that we created are connecting with each other. After this, we can now return back to the object mode. So press Tab and let's also turn off the X-ray mode. And with this object selected, if I zoom in, then you can see that the placement of the cylinder is still not perfect. So I'll go back to the edit mode and we'll scale this down like this. Let's also scale it up in the X-axis to increase its length. Also, let's move it slightly upwards and after all the adjustments, the tuning keys will be completely ready. After this, let's again return back to the object mode and with the tuning keys selected, we'll be applying the bevel modifier to them in order to give them a realistic look. So go to the modifier properties, click on add modifier, then in the generate, select the bevel modifier. Then in the amount, we'll reduce this to a value of 0.07 or 0.05 and if you want, you can also increase the number of segments from here. Then to give it a smooth appearance, right click and apply shade auto smooth. After this, let's now create some more tuning keys to be added on the top. So press 7 on the numpad to go to the top view and with this one selected, press shift plus D to create a duplicate and we'll place this over here. Also, we'll be rotating it slightly in the x-axis but right now, if I try to rotate this tuning key in the x-axis, then you will notice that it is taking this yellow colored point as the origin point. To fix this, simply go to the object menu and in the set origin, select origin to geometry and now if I try to rotate it again in the x-axis, then you will notice that we are easily able to rotate this tuning key. Now let's go to the top view again and now we'll be creating one more tuning key. So press shift plus D to create a duplicate and we'll place this somewhere over here. Let's also move it in the x-axis like this. Then for the rotation, we'll rotate it in the x-axis in order to give it some random rotation. After doing this, we also need to create the same tuning keys on the other side and for this we'll be using the mirror modifier. So with this tuning key selected, I'll go to the modify properties, then click on add modifier and in the generate, select the mirror modifier. Now in order to ensure that the duplicate tuning key because of the mirror modifier is placed at the opposite side of the guitar, we need to make some changes in the mirror modifier. So over here, we have this mirror object option and in this, we basically have to select this guitar object based on which the symmetry will be determined. And you can see in the scene collection that this top part of the guitar is saved with the name plane. Therefore, I'll select this tuning key, then scroll down and in the mirror object, I will select the plane. And after this, the mirror modifier will create a duplicate of the tuning key taking the top of the guitar as the reference object. Similarly, I'll select this tuning key, then go to the modify properties, click on add modifier and in the generate, select the mirror modifier. Let's scroll down and in the mirror object, we'll be selecting the plane. Then in the end, I'll select this tuning key, go to the modify properties, click on add modifier and in the generate, we'll once again select the mirror modifier. Let's scroll down and in the mirror object, we'll be selecting the plane. Now you might be thinking that for this particular tuning key, we were having its duplicate created on the opposite side of the guitar even before we added this plane as the mirror object. And this is because the origin point of this particular tuning key is placed on this Y axis. As a result, the mirror modifier will by default take this origin point as the reference and depending upon this, it will create the symmetrical object on the opposite side. But for the other tuning keys, we were having the origin point placed over here. As a result, the mirror modifier was taking the position of this origin point as the reference and that's the reason why we were having the duplicate placed over here. But by using the mirror object, we told the mirror modifier to take this plane object or the top of guitar as the reference point. Now we'll work on creating the nut which is placed on this part of the guitar. And for this purpose, I'll select the neck of the guitar, press Tab to enter the edit mode, then press 3 for the face select mode and I'll be selecting this particular face. Now with this face selected, we'll basically make a duplicate of it and then we'll convert it into a separate object which will then be used to make the nut of the guitar. So to create the duplicate, press Shift plus D, then right click to cancel the movement. But right now, this duplicate face that we created is only in the edit mode of this object which is the neck of the guitar. And to convert this face into a separate object, we have an option which is called the separate option. To use it, press P and then the separate menu will appear which will ask you that on which basis it should separate the selected geometry. And since we need to separate the geometry based on selection, so we'll be selecting the selection type. After this, press Tab to return to the object mode. Now I'll deselect everything and then if I go to the scene collection and select this plane at the last which is plane.004, then you will see that this face that we created as a duplicate is now converted into a separate object. Now to give it some thickness, press Tab to enter the edit mode. Now I'll select this face and we'll be extruding it in the Z axis. So press E to extrude it in the Z axis and left click to finalize. Let's also reduce its size in the Y axis. So press A to select all, then press S, Y to scale it down in the Y axis. Now left click to finalize and with this, we now have one more part of the guitar ready which is called the nut of the guitar. Now the next part that we'll be making will be this bridge of the guitar. So for this also, we'll be using the same method that we did to model this nut of the guitar. So first of all, return back to the object mode, then select the neck of guitar, press tab to enter the edit mode, and with the face selection mode enabled, we'll be selecting this particular face. Now press shift plus D to create a duplicate, then right click to cancel the movement, and to convert this face into a separate object, press P and click on selection. After this, press tab to return back to the object mode, and we'll be selecting this particular object with the name plane.005. Now to convert it into the bridge of guitar, we'll first move it in the Y axis by pressing G and Y, and we'll place it over here. After that, let's go to the top view by pressing 7 on the numpad. Let's zoom in, and first of all, let's tab into the edit mode, press A to select everything, and we'll extrude it in the Y axis. Also, to scale it up in the X axis, press A to select all and press S and X to scale it up in the X axis. And after doing all these adjustments with the size of this object, the bridge of the guitar will be completely ready. Now let's change the angle, then press 2 for the edge select mode, and I will select this particular edge. Then I'll move it up in the Z axis like this, and we did this because we'll be connecting the strings of the guitar in this expanded region. Now to make the strings of guitar, let's return back to the object mode, then we'll select the neck of the guitar, press tab to enter the edit mode, then press 3 for the face select mode, and we'll be selecting this particular face. Now just like we did for the nut and the bridge, we'll be creating a duplicate of this selected face in order to make the strings of guitar. So press shift plus D to create a duplicate, then right click to cancel the movement, and to convert it into a separate object, press P and click on selection. After this, return back to the object mode, then deselect everything, and now we'll be selecting this plane.006 in the scene collection. Now press tab to enter the edit mode, then press 2 for the edge select mode, and we'll be selecting this edge over here. Now we'll move it in the Y axis in order to connect it with the bridge of guitar. To see everything properly, let's go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad. Let's zoom in and adjust the view. Now press G, Y, and we'll move it forward, and now you can see that we are having this edge of the plane perfectly connected with the bridge of guitar. Moving ahead, press 3 for the face select mode, then select this top face, and now we'll be adding some loop cuts that we later on convert into the strings of guitar. So to add the loop cuts, I'll first keep my cursor over this face, then press Ctrl plus R. Let's move the cursor slightly, and now to increase the number of loop cuts, we'll be using the scroll wheel. And since we need a total of 6 strings in the guitar, as a result, we'll be adding 4 loop cuts because we already have the two side edges. Now left click to finalize and right click to cancel the movement. Now to scale them down, press 3 for the face select mode, then press A to select all, and we'll scale this down in the X axis. Now left click to finalize. Now if I deselect them and return back to the object mode, then you will see that instead of having the strings, we are having only this face. And to convert it into the strings with the help of these edges, we'll get back to the edit mode, then press Alt plus Z to turn on the X-ray mode, and also press 2 for the edge select mode, and now we have to select these corner edges present on both the sides. So we'll select them on this side, and similarly, let's also select them on the other side with the shift key holded. After this, press X, and in the delete option, select edges. Now if I turn off the X-ray mode and return back to the object mode, then you can see here that we are now having these edges that we'll be using as the strings of the guitar. Also, press tab to enter the edit mode, and let's scale them up so that the strings are connected with the nut on this side. So press A to select all, and we'll slightly scale it up in the Y axis. Now moving ahead, the next thing that we'll be doing is to give some thickness to these strings. But in order to do this, we first have to convert these strings into curves. So for those of you who don't know, in Blender, there are different types of objects. And if I return back to the object mode and press shift plus A, then all the categories of objects can be seen from this list. The first and the most used is the mesh category, where you have all the mesh objects like the cube, the UV sphere, the cylinder. And then on the second number, we have the curve, where we have the Bezier curve, the circle, the hair and fur. Then we have the text category, about which we also learned in the last chapter of this course. And Blender also gives you the option to convert a mesh object into a curve. And to do this thing, with the string selected in the object mode, right click, then go to convert to, and from this list, select the curves. Now to give them some thickness, we'll go to the object data properties by clicking on this icon, and from here, you can change how the curve looks. So in the geometry, we have several options like the extrusion effect, the bevel effect, and for now, we'll be using the bevel effect in order to give the string some thickness. So in the depth, we'll increase it to a value of somewhere around 0.01 or 0.09, and after this, we'll have the strings of the guitar ready in our scene. Now to finalize the model, we'll be applying the bevel and the subdivision surface modifier to the different parts of the guitar. So first of all, we'll select this neck of the guitar and go to the modify properties, then click on add modifier, and in the generate, we'll be selecting the bevel modifier. Now in the number of segments, we'll increase this to a value of 2, and we'll reduce the amount in order to give it a slightly rounded and a natural appearance. Let's also apply the subdivision surface modifier to it to give it a more natural look. So go to the modify properties, click on add modifier, then in the generate, select the subdivision surface modifier. Let's scroll down, and in the levels viewport, we'll enter the value equal to 2. Now just like this, we'll now select this nut of the guitar, then go to the modify properties, click on add modifier, and in the generate, select the bevel modifier. Then we'll increase the number of segments to 2, and we'll reduce the amount to a value of around 0.02 meters. Also, let's move it slightly ahead in the y-axis. axis in order to make sure that it is connecting with the strings of guitar. Let's also go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad, zoom in, and with the nut selected, we'll move this down in the Z axis. So let's place it over here, and after this, let's also apply the subdivision surface modifier to it. So go to the modify properties, click on add modifier, and in the generate, select the subdivision surface modifier. Let's scroll down and increase the levels viewport to a value of 2. Then in the end, we'll be selecting this bridge of the guitar, then go to the modify properties, and in the generate category, select the bevel modifier. Now increase the number of segments to a value of 2, and let's also reduce the amount from here. So we'll keep it to a value of 0.02, and after this, let's also apply the subdivision surface modifier to it. And after this, the 3D model of the guitar will be completely ready. And so now it's the time to create some materials for this guitar model. So to do this, let's first go to the material preview mode by clicking on this icon. After this, I'll first select this lower part of the guitar, and to create the material, we'll be adding the shader editor window. So we'll change this window, which is the timeline editor, into the shader editor, and for this, click on this icon, and from this list, we'll be selecting the shader editor. Now to create a new material, click on the new button, let's zoom in, and now we'll be creating a wood-like texture for the guitar body. And for this purpose, we'll be using the noise texture. So press Shift plus A, then go to the texture, and from here, select the noise texture. Let's place it over here. Now connect the factor socket to the base color, and in order to create a wooden texture with some streaks, we'll be using the vector mapping node in the shader editor. By using it, we'll be changing the scale values of the texture in a particular axis. So in the shader editor, press Shift plus A, then go to vector and select the mapping node. We'll place it over here and connect the vector socket in the mapping node to the vector in the noise texture. And after this, we also need to add a texture coordinate node, which will be used as the input for the vector in this mapping node. So press Shift plus A, then go to input, and from here, we'll be selecting the texture coordinate node. Let's place it over here and connect the object socket to the vector. And after this, we'll be able to see the noise texture applied on the object. Now to create the streaks for the wood texture, we have to use the scaling values in the mapping node. So right now, if I try to increase the scale value in the x-axis, then you will notice that we are able to get a texture with some streaks applied on the guitar body. And to make it look like the wood texture, we need to change its color. And for this purpose, we'll be using the color ramp node. So press Shift plus A, then go to converter and select the color ramp. We'll place it in between the noise texture and the principal BSDF. Now with this pointer selected, which is black in color, if I try to move it by left clicking and dragging, then you will see that the amount of black color in the guitar is changing. So this pointer will control the black color in the texture, which is used for creating the streaks, and this white pointer will be used to control the other color, which we can set by clicking here. Now in order to create a wood-like texture, we'll first reduce the brightness of the colors from here, and then we'll change this to the orange color or the brown color. And yes, by changing the color in the color wheel, we are able to see different kind of colors which can be used for the guitar's body. But in this case, I will be choosing this brown color texture since we are able to get a wood-like texture. Also, if you want, you can try to move these pointers in different directions in order to change the amount of color in this wood material. After this, let's also give it a smooth and a shinier look by reducing the roughness value in the principal BSDF to 0.2, and to see how the rendered version will look, we'll go to the render view. So click on this icon, and let's also change the render engine by going to the render properties, and we'll change this from EV to cycles. Now if I zoom out, then you will see that even though the texture is applied properly, but we are getting slight cracks in the geometry around this region. And to fix this, we have to make some changes in the edit mode. So first of all, let's go back to the solid mode, and with the body of guitar selected, press tab, and to see everything properly, we'll disable the real-time display of the subdivision surface modifier, because it will allow us to see the original vertices and the edges of the object without the subdivision effect applied to them. And to do this, just go to the subdivision surface modifier and click on this icon which has the name real-time display. After this, press 1 for the vertex select mode, and we are seeing this error because we applied the inset faces on the top and the bottom side. So to solve this problem, we'll basically delete this particular edge loop which is created because of the inset faces effect. So to do this, press the Alt button and left click over here, then press X to delete and select delete vertices. Similarly, let's also delete the edge loop on this other side also. So by holding the Alt key, we'll select this edge loop, then press X to delete and select delete vertices. Now to fill the face on the top, we'll be selecting this original edge loop present on the top by holding Alt and left clicking over here, and then we'll use the shortcut to fill the face, which is to press F. Now return back to the object mode, and to see how it looks with the subdivision applied, we'll turn on the real-time display. After this, let's also go to the render view, and now you can see that we are no longer having any errors in the geometry of the guitar. Now moving ahead, let's also create some material for the neck of the guitar. And for this purpose, I'll first select this object, and for this one, we'll be creating a material similar to this wood texture but slightly darker. And to do this, let's go to the shader editor, click on this icon, and select this material which we used for the body of guitar. But right now, if I try to do any changes to the selected material, then it will get applied to both the objects. And to solve this problem, we have to create a duplicate of this wood material and then apply the changes to it. And to do this, go to the shader editor and click on this icon. By doing this, the name of the material will change, and now if I do any changes to the material, then they will get applied only to the neck of guitar. Now for the selected object, we'll reduce the brightness of the color in order to make it slightly darker. Then moving ahead, in order to get a realistic look of the material, click on this icon and in the lighting, turn off the scene world. And now you can see that there's a clear difference between the wood texture that we use for this lower part or the body of the guitar and the one that we used for this object, which is the neck of the guitar. Now let's also create the material for the strings of the guitar. So I'll first select them, then go to the shader editor, click on the new button, and to give them a metallic look, I'll change the metallic value to a higher number like 0.8 or 0.9, and then I'll also reduce the roughness to a much lower number like 0.1 or 0.2. Then for the base color, I'll change this to the gray color. So reduce the brightness from here, and finally this is how the strings of the guitar are looking in our scene. Similarly, let's also create the material for these tuning keys. So I'll select this one, then go to the shader editor and create a new material. After this, in order to give them a metallic look, I'll go to the metallic property and increase this to 0.8 or 0.9, and then in the roughness, we'll enter a value which is very low, for example 0.1 or 0.2, and now if I zoom in, then you can clearly see the difference between the material of this tuning key and the ones without any metallic material. Moving ahead, if you want, you can change the base color to any color of your choice by using the color wheel, and you can also reduce the brightness of the color from here. But for now, I will go with the default values, which is the white as the base color. And to apply the same material to the remaining tuning keys, I'll select one of them, then go to the shader editor, click on this icon, and from here, I will select this last material that we created for the tuning keys. One more thing, if you want to change the name of any material, then you can click here, and if I type any name, then the material will get renamed. Now press enter to confirm, and in this way, you can change the name of any material in the shader editor. For example, if I select the neck of the guitar, then this material will appear with the name material.001, but if I left click over here, then I can change its name like this. Similarly, I'll select the strings of the guitar and change the name from material.002 to strings. And after this, let's also rename the material that we created for the body of guitar. So I'll select it, and in the shader editor, we'll change the name of this material to wood. Now the next thing that we'll do is to create a material for the nut and the bridge object. So first of all, I will select the nut of the guitar, and in this case, we'll be using the same wood texture but with a different color. So go to the shader editor, click on this icon, and from here, I will select the second wood material that we used for the neck of the guitar. Then to make the changes, first click on this icon to create the duplicate of the material. Then in the color ramp, with the second pointer selected, I'll change the color from brown to something like blue or purple. And yes, it totally depends upon you that which color you want to add to any part of the guitar. It might be possible that for your guitar, some other color like green or maybe blue will look better instead of the one that I will select in this case. Now moving ahead, let's apply the same material to the bridge object also. So for this, let's select this bridge, then go to the shader editor, click on this icon, and we'll select the material that we just created. And with this, we have successfully created all the materials for the different parts of this guitar. Now go to the solid mode, and we'll be doing some minor adjustments in the guitar mesh. So first of all, I'll go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad. Let's zoom in, and you can see over here that there's a little space in between the neck, bridge, and the body of the guitar. And to fix this, we'll first select all these parts, including the bridge and the neck of guitar, and also the tuning keys. And if anything is left behind, then you can select that as well by holding the shift button and then select it. After this, let's zoom in, and we have to move this down in the Z axis. So press G, Z, and let's slightly move it down so that it begins to touch the body of guitar. Now left click to finalize. Also, let's apply the shade auto smooth to some parts of the guitar like the bridge. So I'll select it, then right click and apply shade auto smooth. Similarly, let's also apply it to the neck of the guitar. So right click and apply shade auto smooth. And just like this, we'll also apply it to the nut. So I'll select it, then right click and apply shade auto smooth. And with this, our 3D model of a guitar is completely ready. Now press 0 on the numpad to go to the camera view, and to make it ready for rendering, let's add a base and a background. So for this, let's again go to the solid mode. Now to add the base, press shift plus A, then go to mesh and select the plane. Press tab to go to the edit mode, and we'll scale it up 10 times. After this, press 2 for the edge select mode, and now we'll be selecting this particular edge and we'll extrude it up to form the background. So press E to extrude it in the Z axis and left click. Also, to give this middle part a slightly curved appearance, I'll select this edge. Now press Ctrl plus B to apply the bevel tool, then move the cursor away, and to increase the amount of roundness, I will use the scroll wheel, and this will increase the number of loop cuts. Now left click to finalize, and let's also come out of the edit mode. Now right click and apply shade auto smooth, and let's now place this guitar that we created in such a position that it is inclined to the plane. So for this, let's go to the side view by pressing 3 on the numpad, and we'll be selecting the entire body of the guitar. Also, it might be possible that some other objects like the plane and the light will also get selected along with the guitar model. And to deselect them, simply press the control button And if I left click and drag my cursor over that particular object and then release it, then it will get deselected. Similarly, let's also do the same thing with this light, and now we are having only the guitar selected. Now press 3 on the numpad to go to the side view, and also to see the plane, we'll change the mode from solid to the wireframe mode. So click on this icon, and now we are able to see the wireframe display of the plane added. Now with the guitar selected, press R to rotate it like this, then press G to move it and place it over here. Now we'll make some adjustments to make sure that the guitar is inclined with this wall. Also, if you want, you can scale it up and down by pressing S if you want to increase or decrease the size of the guitar model. And once the position of the guitar is fixed, we'll go to the camera view by pressing 0 on the numpad, and let's also change this to the solid mode. Now to adjust the position of camera, click on this icon, and now by using the middle mouse button, we'll be able to change the position of the camera. So let's zoom in and adjust the camera properly, and once it is done, we'll work on the lighting part so that we can finally render the image of the guitar. So let's go to the rendered view, then click here, and let's also turn on the scene world. Let's also deselect everything, and now we need to create some lights in order to finalize our scene. So I'll select this lamp, then press 7 on the numpad to go to the top view. Let's zoom out, and we'll first place it at a position close to the guitar. Now press shift plus D to create a duplicate, and we'll move it in the X axis. Also, with the light selected, if I click on this icon, which is the object data properties, then from here we can change the color of the lights and also the power of the light. So for the color, I have selected a light shade of purple for this selected light. Let's also select this light, and for this one, I'll change the color to a light shade of pink. Now to see how the image looks, let's go to the camera view again by pressing 0 on the numpad, and with the light selected, I'll reduce its power to 400 watts. Similarly, for this one also, I'll select it and reduce the power to 400 watts. Now go to the top view again, and with this light selected, press shift plus D to create a duplicate, and we'll place it in front of the guitar. Then in the color, we'll change this to the white color, and in the power, we'll enter a value of 800 watts. But because of doing this, the effect of these colored lights that we added has now reduced. So with both of them selected, we'll move them in the Y axis and place them close to the guitar. Now to see how everything looks, let's go to the camera view again, and finally this is how our scene is looking. Now for the background, I'll select this plane, then go to the shader editor, click on the new button, and in the base color, I'll reduce the brightness and we'll change this to the purple color. Let's also increase the roughness value to 0.8, and now our scene is almost ready. The only thing that I can see here that we can still improve is the lighting effect on the guitar because of this specific light. So I'll slightly move it down in the X axis like this so that we are not having that impact of the white light falling on the guitar. Let's also increase its power from 800 to 1000 watt, and after this, we are now ready to render this image. So click on render and select render image. And now the image of the guitar is being rendered, and you can check the status of rendering from the number of samples which have been rendered out of the total number of samples, which is 4096 by default. And once the image is rendered, you can save it by going to the image menu, and from here, you can click on the save button after rendering the image. But for now, I'll close this window, and with this, we have now arrived to the end of the chapter number 2. Today we learnt about some new modeling techniques. Like first of all, we learned to create a complete mesh just from a single vertex by extruding it. After that, we learned about separating an object in the edit mode. Then we created the strings by converting them into curves. And then we also created some basic materials for this guitar scene. And at last, we made this lighting and the rendering setup in order to render the final image of the guitar. And yes, if you managed to complete this chapter number 2 and even created the 3D model of this guitar, then don't forget to share the rendered images on the Discord server, which you can join by using the link given in the description. Also, if you wish to download this 3D model of the guitar that I created in this chapter, then you can join the Patreon of this channel, whose link is available in the description of this video. And so our next chapter will be the chapter number 3, where we'll be creating a 3D model of a radio and its different parts. And in this way, we'll be practicing some more modeling tools in Blender. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel, press that notification bell so that you can get timely updates about the upcoming chapters. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.